is because we all have realized that without this science, we cannot become a superpower. And we are trying to become a superpower, as you all know. So what I'm trying to tell you is that you must analyze your strengths and weaknesses. Just because, unfortunately, we all belong to a country where we have very strong hierarchies. Hierarchy means, you know, for example, you belong to X religion, you belong to Y community. No, they have a higher status. Some other religion and some other community have lower, you know, status in our eyes. And the same feudal attitude has been carried into our services. I belong to the IA, so I am a new kind of a Brahmin. And I belong to the, I joined the Indian Police Service, I am a little inferior to that. I joined the army, I am some other category. No, this feudal attitude unfortunately has been carried from our social life into our work culture. So that is slowly now getting wiped out. Very luckily, after the liberalization, you know what is liberalization? You know, where now we don't have much of licenses. Anybody is free to do anything he wants. Earlier, if you wanted to set up an industry, you have to actually go to 100 offices. Today, you have to go to only 16 offices. It has come down from 100 to 16. A day will come when you only have only 16 offices. You may have to online simply punch in what you want to do and you get a license. Get it? So therefore, today, the liberalization has given tremendous opportunity to every individual to excel himself or herself, irrespective of the background that you come from. So if we are going to live in this kind of environment, now it's not necessary for you to be in a position which is traditionally considered very important. You don't have to be a deputy commissioner to command a respect. You can be a professor and command a respect. For example, if the professor is the prime minister of this country, you right, you know all that. Today, the prime minister of this country is, as a professor who started teaching economics is jealous that college is a job. And he moved from teaching economics to do his research subsequently in one of the universities and joined the planning commission and became anything, everything that an intellectual can become. We had a president who was a teacher. Or today we have numerous teachers, you know, who actually have excelled in politics, who have excelled in writing books, who have excelled, you know, in running institutes. There are many examples. Or we have our own example, for example, Captain Gopinath, you know, who left army to run his own, Deccan Aviation. So there are innumerable examples like that. Okay, we really should.